Well, one of the creators of AstraZeneca's COVID-19 vaccine says coronavirus may not be the last pandemic we see, nor the worst. Details in this report.
The spread of the Omicron variant is fueling fears of yet another global surge in coronavirus cases, as health officials and pharmaceutical firms race to develop targeted vaccines and COVID-19 treatments. At least one vaccine expert warned this pandemic would not be the last.
This will not be the last time a virus threatens our lives and our livelihoods.
Sarah Gilbert, one of the creators of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, told an audience at Oxford University on Monday that nations must make an enduring commitment to pandemic preparedness.
And I'd like to finish on a high note, but the truth is the next one could be worse. It could be more contagious or more lethal or both. We cannot allow a situation where we have gone through all we have gone through, and then find that the enormous economic losses we have sustained mean that there is still no funding for pandemic preparedness. The advances we have made and the knowledge we have gained must not be lost.
The novel coronavirus has killed 5.26 million people across the world, according to Johns Hopkins University. Closures and health restrictions wiped out trillions of dollars in economic output and turned life upside down for billions of people. Gilbert, a professor of vaccinology at the University of Oxford, said that amid the battle against this pandemic, the world should not lose sight of the threat posed by the next one.
Just as we invest in armed forces and intelligence and diplomacy to defend against wars, we must invest in people, research, manufacturing, and institutions to defend against pandemics.
Over in the U.S., New York City is expanding its vaccine mandate to include all private sector employees and children over 5 years old. More in this report.
And we have to move quickly. And that's why I describe the actions we're taking today as a preemptive strike. Get ahead of this problem before it deepens and use the thing that works, vaccination.
As the holidays and colder weather collide with the highly transmissible Omicron variants, New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio is doubling down on the fight against COVID-19. The mayor announcing Monday that starting December 27th, all private sector employers must ensure their workers have been fully vaccinated. The mandate, de Blasio said, is the first of its kind in the nation.
It is time. Look, this is how we put health and safety first. By ensuring that there is a vaccine mandate that reaches everyone universally in the private sector.
In addition, children 5 to 11 years old must get at least one vaccine dose by December 14th to enter restaurants and to participate in extracurricular school activities such as sports, band, orchestra, and dance.
Only one dose required. There's time for parents to get that done.
Patrons over the age of 12 must also be fully vaccinated in order to enter businesses after December 27th. The requirements come at a time when new coronavirus infections are accelerating nationwide, especially in northern states, and as the highly transmissible Omicron variant has spread to at least one-third of U.S. states.
Manila's search for 8 travelers from South Africa hits a snag. Philippine authorities have yet to locate them, saying the travelers provided incorrect personal information. Some of them gave incomplete addresses, while 2 individuals are not answering their phone calls. The health department is coordinating with different agencies and localities to find them.
These are the challenges that we are now faced with these travelers, but we are coordinating with the different local governments po. We already flagged the Bureau of Quarantine and the Department of Transportation regarding this matter so that they can coordinate with the specific agencies of these individuals.
The Philippines is tracking dozens of travelers who have arrived in the country between November 15 and 29 before stricter rules were imposed due to the threat of the Omicron variant. South Africa was the first country to report the emergence of the latest COVID-19 variant. Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte sees better days ahead for Filipinos as the COVID-19 situation in the country improves further. On Monday, the Philippines logged 543 new COVID-19 infections, marking the 8th straight day. Fresh cases came in below 700. Duterte said he's very happy with the decline in cases and he's confident the Philippines can cope with the possible entry of the Omicron variant.
Christmas na, I hope that everything will be for the good of everybody, and I am very happy that bumababa na talaga, dumadive na yung ano, that's a miracle, because other countries are still reeling from the effect, parang nagkaroon sila ng problema sa Omicron. So tayo, we are not hoping for the best, but we pray to God that it will not come to our shores. But if ever, if the thing na we can cope up with it just as we did with COVID-19.
Health Secretary Francisco Duque also assuring Filipinos government is preparing for the possible entry of the Omicron variant. Duque admits, though, it's only a matter of time before the variant reaches the country.
Meron tayong four-core strategy na ginagamit. Yung point of origin, meron tayong mga red-listed countries. May travel ban tayo except for the Filipinos, mga OFWs, of course. Yung health system's capacity ng hospital natin, pinalawin natin ang kanilang kapasidad, yung bed utilization, at yung ating ICU, mechanical ventilators, ay sinisiguro natin na kakayanin tumugon in case magkaroon ng worst case scenario or sustained high community transmission.
Duque, meanwhile, sees no more easing of health measures in the coming weeks.
Para sa akin, dapat siguro tama lang manatili muna tayo sa alert level 2. Bakit kamo? Unang-una ay ang mobility, tataas na naman ngayong kapaskuhan. Alam natin yan, no? At meron nagmamadyan o banta ng Omicron.
The Philippines aims to administer 7 million COVID-19 shots during the second round of its mass vaccination drive next week. During the first round of the National Vaccination Days, government was able to administer some 10 million shots from November 29th to December 3rd. The second leg is set on December 15th to 17th. Health officials urge Filipinos to get vaccinated due to the threat of the Omicron variant. So far, 38.1 million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19, or nearly 50% of government's 77 million target.